Hey guys, Motor Missile over here. I just wanted to do a quick knife review of one of my everyday folders. This is a knife I use a lot. I use this every day for just mundane tasks, opening plastic, packaging, cleaning my nails, cutting anything that may need cutting. It's a pretty unexciting, inexpensive blade. It's definitely not the nicest folder out there, but for the price, you know, you're really getting a great knife. I only paid about $25 for this one. You can find them online anywhere from $25 to $60. Really good craftsmanship. It's a Eka Swede 8 made by Eka Knife Company based out of Sweden. The steel on this, I don't know if you can see it here. This is just my cell phone, but this is a 12C27 Sandvik stainless steel, which is comparable to a 440 stainless, probably a little bit better. Not a whole lot of features on this knife. It's just a two-handed opening block back. It's got Babinga scales, which are decent. Not real crazy about the wood scales on this. It's got really good jimping on the spine. Little thumbnail niche here. Came pretty sharp out of the box. I've been using this one for over a year now, so I've sharpened it many times, and it's got pretty decent edge retention. It will wear out, and you'll need to sharpen it, but not too often. I can't really find too many flaws on this knife. The only thing I really don't like about it is the little Eka logo, which is recessed into the wood. It's a little uneven. I don't know if it'll pick it up on the camera here, but the left side of that logo is recessed in further than the right. It just bothers me for some reason. A tiny little mundane detail doesn't really affect the knife at all, but this is a great carry knife. I think it's seven and a quarter inches overall length. The blade is only about 3 inches, and it's about four inches long closed. So it's not a big knife. It's perfect for carrying around. But yet the blade's big enough to do most tasks. As I said, it's not really a defense knife or anything like that. It's just a good all-around utility knife. No lanyard hold or nothing on this one. No fancy thumb studs. Just a two-handed opening closing pocket knife. But yeah, I highly recommend it for the price. This is a good knife. You're getting a really good knife that's going to last you a long time. The craftsmanship on these things are pretty good. People who have them swear by them. Again, for $25-$30, you really can't beat a solid knife. Just listen to the lockup. So it's very satisfying lockup on it. It's a quality knife, inexpensive. It's not really too impressive or anything, but it's not scary either. It's not gonna intimidate anybody when you pull it out or nothing like that. Mine didn't come with a sheath or anything like that. In different markets, they do come with cases and sheaths, but this one just came with a box, and that's pretty much it. What you see is what you get, which is fine by me. So that's pretty much it. I just ordered a Spyderco Sage 2. I'm waiting on that to come in, and I'm excited to share that with you guys once that arrives. That's pretty much it. If you guys have any questions or anything, please comment below. I really recommend this knife a lot. If you're looking for just something practical, reliable, and legal in most places, not that that's an issue for me, but if you live in Germany or something like that, this is a totally legal knife to carry, and it's just an excellent part of your EDC. So thanks for watching, guys. Till next time, this is Motor Missile. See you guys later.